गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू विल बी फाइन एंड यू विल बी डूइंग गुड. स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर इंग्लिश लेसन एंड इन दिस इंग्लिश लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अ स्टोरी द बज डॉल, यूनिट नंबर 4 फ्रॉम ऑक्सफोर्ड रीडिंग सर्कल. सो आई वॉन्ट यू टू ओपन योर ऑक्सफोर्ड रीडिंग सर्कल बुक्स एंड स्टार्ट रीडिंग विद मी. लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर लेसन. द बज डॉल. वेल डन दीबा, we are so proud of you. Deepa sat up in bed and rubbed her sleepy eyes. The room was full of people. Mom and dad were there, and so was her sister Neha, her brother Rafi, and even Auntie Anita. It was 6 o'clock in the morning on Sunday. Deepa did not have to go to school, so there was no need to rise at 6. But Deepa was not annoyed. Annoyed means feeling angry. Yesterday she had been given some good news. She had come first in her class. She was now delighted to be up. Delighted means extremely pleased. The family had promised her some presents, and here they were. Wake up, sleepyhead, shouted Neha, jumping up and down at the bottom of her bed. Rafi stepped forward and handed her a large parcel. Well done, Deepa, he said, and added, open this one first. I wrapped it myself. What is it? Asked Deepa excitedly. Excited means happily, taking the parcel from him. Open it and find out, said Rafi. And before you say anything, I bought it with my own money. I knew you would come first, so I have been saving up for months and months and months and... Yes, yes, interrupted Dad. Interrupted mean halted the flow of a speaker. Mom and I know how much you saved. Don't tell Deepa how much you owe the bank. But Dad, wailed Rafi, I did save a lot. Wailed mean cried. Didn't I? I only borrowed a little bit from you. Deepa was not listening. She was busy unwrapping the parcel. A doll, she exclaimed when the paper was off. How lovely. Thank you, Rafi. It is no ordinary doll. Ordinary, normal, usual. Quickly, just in case, she thought it was. It works on batteries and it talks. Let me show you how it. Let her do it on her own, Rafi, said Mom, gently holding Rafi back. It's her big day and her present, so let her make it work. I was only going to help her with the batteries, complained Rafi. It won't work without them, and putting them in is complicated. Complicated means difficult. I'm sure she will manage, said Dad, handing her a small packet of batteries. After all, she has proved that she is the brightest girl. Deepa tore the packet open, removed the back cover of the doll, and fitted the batteries in no time. How do you make it talk? She asked. See, I told you, said Rafi, smiling smugly. Smugly mean in a self-satisfied way. At his parents, she does need help, after all, and big brothers are here to do just that. And before he could be stopped, Rafi pressed a tiny button on the side of the doll. Now, say something, Deepa, he said. Give the doll an instruction like attack or fire. And the doll will remember and use the words later on. Goodness me, what words? Said Mom. I don't think this doll is going to be doing any attacking or firing, Rafi. It is not like your action man or battle warrior or Tarzan, but a beautiful girl doll. Deepa took control. She held the doll close and said, pretty baby, beautiful flower, buttercup, blue sky, please sit. Please don't do that. Hello, sweetie. Rafi shook his head, let his jaw drop, and rolled his eyes. He looked as if he was in deep agony. Agony meant pain and distress. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear, he said. Your doll will learn language sweeter than Auntie Anita's sticky toffee pudding. Everyone laughed, including Auntie Anita. Over the next half hour, Deepa opened the presents. She was thrilled with all of them. The doll lay beside her bed while she examined them. Then it was time for breakfast and the family moved downstairs. After breakfast, Deepa helped mom to wash up. Rafi disappeared. Perhaps he was in the garden helping dad to fix the gate. Deepa went to her room to play with her new toys. She put on the green goggles Auntie Anita had given her. She was becoming quite a good swimmer, so the goggles would be very useful. She would be able to swim for ages without getting red eyes. Deepa practiced a few strokes of the crawl. Mom and Dad's present is going to be useful too, thought Deepa, picking up a paintbrush. They had given her an easel, paper and a set of watercolors. She would certainly have fun with those. Mrs. Khan, her art teacher, would be pleased. Put it down now, growled a voice from the corner of the room. Deepa jumped and dropped the paintbrush. Rafi, is that you? Asked Deepa, looking round the room. The voice did not sound like Rafi's, and Deepa was a little afraid. Afraid meant fearful. If you are hiding and trying to scare me, said Deepa, trying to sound bold, you are doing a good job. I shall find you. Run, run, came a shrill voice. Shrill voice, harsh voice, high-pitched voice from near the bed. Scatter, we are under attack. The voice was loud and gruff. Gruff mean rough. Deepa expected something to come flying across the room. She sat on the floor and covered her head with her hands. There was a loud wail. This was followed by angry shouting and lots of instructions. Stay down, came the voice. We are under attack. Load your weapons and be ready to fire. One, two, three, duck, duck, kaboom. There was a loud crack, followed by gunfire, then silence. Deepa breathed ever so quietly. She was creeping towards the door to escape. Then she heard the voice again. Aha, I'll get you, I'll get you. From her position on the floor, Deepa spotted her doll. The doll's arms were moving up and down frantically. Frantically mean with great excitement. And her eyes were flashing. Rafi, said the doll in Rafi's voice. You have been a very naughty boy. Ha ha ha. Deepa burst into laughter. Wait till I catch that brother of mine. She shrieked as she ran downstairs to find Rafi. Students, now come to the questions of unit number 4. Question number 1 is, why were so many people in Deepa's room? Answer is, they wanted to give her presents because she had stood first in class and they were proud of her. Question number 2, how do you know that Rafi was proud of his present? Answer, we know Rafi was proud because he was eager to show Deepa how the doll worked and he had saved money for months to buy the present. Question number 3, what kind of language do you think Deepa wanted the doll to use? How did Rafi react to this language? Answer, Deepa wanted the doll to learn a polite language. Rafi was agonized with the sweet prattle that Deepa was trying to teach the doll. Question number 4. Describe the kind of toys you think Rafe played with. Answer. Rafe loved to play with toys with which he could attack or fire, such as Tarzan, Battle Warriors, or Action Man. Question 5. What presents did Deeba receive and from whom? Answer. Deeba received a talking doll from Rafe, green goggles from Aunt Anita, and a painting kit, easel paper, watercolors, paintbrush from her parents.